Thanks, Arthur. Okay, 2:03. I call this meeting to order. It is what is today? Tuesday, June 4th, 2024. And the first item on the agenda is review and approve the meeting minutes of May 7th, 2024.
Actually, before we do that, we need to take roll.
Oh, excuse me. Yep, that's correct. We'll do roll call. I'll start with myself, Meyer Cummins. I work for the DAGS Land Survey Division for the state.
Arthur Butos, Office of Planning and Sustainable Development.
Holly McEldowney, the Department of Land and Natural Resources.
Lily Makaila, Department of Hawaiian Homelands.
Okay, and then we have Jenny Runyon, and we are also joined by Shelley Zahneiser. I hope I'm saying that correctly. And then looks like we also have Regina Hilo visiting us for this meeting as well. Okay, sorry. So we'll get to the first item, which is review, or excuse me, second item, review and approval of meeting minutes for May 7th, 2024. So if the board can take a few minutes to review. Arthur, thanks again for putting this together. I know it's not easy, but it's a lot, so thank you.
No problem. And last month's meeting was a relatively short meeting. It was only an hour, and we didn't actually make any decisions. We put a lot of stuff off. And I think at that meeting, too, we only had four people.
Yeah,
Although,
there wasn't a heck of a lot of us.
yeah, I think Kapaa joined sort of literally at the last minute.
Yeah. And if there are no objections,
I can.
that's
That's
I
true.
read through it. It looked coherent.
yeah, it looked coherent to me as well. If no one has any comments or changes, if I could get a motion to accept the minutes.
Motion to accept.
Okay. Do I have a second?
I'll second it.
Okay, motion made by Lily, seconded by Holly to accept the minutes from May 7th, 2024. Any discussion? Okay, hearing none. All in favor of the motion, vote aye.
Aye.
Raise your hand. Okay, motion passed. Thank you very much. Okay, next item three, public comments. Any public comments, Arthur?
I included a couple of emails I received. One was from Shelby Borkin. I'm probably butchering that name. Who works with the USBGN? I guess he's a contractor, he or she, a contractor with the USBGN. Asking for a follow-up on the Reyes Beach name, which we had deferred till we heard from the family. I'll reach out to them again. I think I said that at the last meeting, but I will reach out to them again to see if they want to attend to talk about the proposal. And then one from David Fogel. His email address was at apple.com. I don't know if that means he actually works for Apple, but he was asking about authoritative names for Hawaii. He was aware of our website. He's seen the spreadsheets or the PDFs. He was actually asking if they were available in a spreadsheet form, and I pointed him to the domestic name, the USBGN, the GNIS site, because that has our updated names in it for the most part. Jenny, I see your hand
Great.
up.
Yeah.
Yeah, thank you, Arthur. Thank you, Meyer. Well, first of all, yes, you're at Shelby Birkin. Yes, she is our new, as of last summer, contractor to the BGN staff. And she's been taking on a lot of the quote, routine proposal work. And as you know, we don't get a lot of proposals for new names for features in Hawaii. And so, yeah, you know, we ask her every month or two to follow up with state names authorities, counties, so forth on the status. So I'm glad she did that and reached out to you. But we've made a note that the Hawaii board is waiting to hear from the proponent. And at this point, I assume the ball's in her court to respond to you with a presentation. and yeah, as far as David Fogel, yeah, he is with Apple Maps. He's a longtime cartographer or I guess geographer there. He and I actually chat every couple of months, and I'll give you a heads up. If you agree to have a chat with David, he says, I just need 30 minutes. Make sure you set aside 3 hours. We just talk forever. He's absolutely fascinated with GNIS and the BGN process and how the state names authorities were involved. And he really wants Apple Maps to be a lot more proactive in picking up official names. And so he wants to learn more about how names go into GNIS. Again, the role of state names authorities. He's been attending the US BGN meetings now for probably close to a year. It's just an observer. And at some point we've asked him to give a presentation, if you would, on Apple Maps and how they actually respond to the public's requests for names. Because of course people will go to Apple and Google just as much as they come to us. So at some point at one of our meetings, we probably will have a presentation from Apple Maps on their naming processes, recognizing they're not a federal agency. So of course they're not bound by BGN decisions, but they really want to follow GNIS where they can. So kind of explains why he reached out to you to see if you have a separate database. And I'm glad you informed him. You pretty much rely on GNIS, so we're on the same page already. So just fill in the gaps there.
Interesting. And we actually submitted a budget proposal a few years back to hire a consultant to put our thing into a good database, but of course, you know, budget cutbacks and all that. It never made it past the department budget review. So still a good idea.
Yeah.
We'd probably model it something after the GNIS, but yeah, I think the GNIS is still probably the best authoritative source that we can point people to.
Yeah. We certainly try. And this is, you know, a large part of why Shelley is on board with us now is she's hopefully got some good ideas on modernization of GNIS. How can we make the process more, maybe more responsive, certainly be more educational to the general public when they try to propose a name. Obviously Hawaii is somewhat unique in that you're really working through existing names. But when a proposal comes up, you know, knowing what people need to do. So thanks. Yeah. A lot of federal agencies are the same. You know, they think about developing their own database, but when it comes right down to it, they say, oh, you know, GNIS is already out there. It's good enough. So thank you.
Thanks, Jenny. Thanks, Arthur.
Yep, and that was it.
I did want to comment on the Reyes Beach proposal. I know that we had previously talked about it a little bit. I think one issue that I have is in the, I guess, application, it mentions that it's an unnamed beach. And it may be an unnamed feature in GNIS, but I would highly doubt that it's actually an unnamed beach. And so I think that that is something that would need to be included from the applicant. I would expect some type of, I guess, historical information or, you know, perhaps a little bit of research that we can do on our end to identify, I guess, the traditional names of that place and even some type of consultation with lineal or cultural descendants that might have kuleana to that place. I know when we looked it up, it was adjacent to what's called Pahonu, which is the, I guess, the turtle fish pond that's located there in Waimanalo, and that has several different community organizations that have affiliation: Waimanalo Limuhui, Ke Kulanui o Waimanalo, and then even just folks who work on Pahonu itself, which are, and they're very active in the neighborhood board as well. And so I think that there would need to be a level of kind of consultation with folks in order to kind of propose a new name for a currently unnamed feature that would be a memorial type of name. And that actually may be a more arduous pathway for the applicant than perhaps reaching out to something like a school or a community park, or, you know, like a non-geographic feature, in order to have more of a memorial type of name. Not sure if this type of thing has been discussed with the board previously, but just wanted to share some of my immediate thoughts on that.
Thanks, Lily. Yeah, I agree with you. I mean, the beach clearly has a name, whether the applicant knows it or not. And I think it would be respectful to the people who are associated and involved with that beach. It's funny, I actually surveyed that lot before they built the house over there. So I'm familiar with it. But yeah, I think it would be important to certainly touch bases, have a conversation, at least include the name of the, you know, the traditional name of the beach, just acknowledge it. I think that's important. I don't know, is that an action item we have to vote on, Arthur, or is that something we can?
No, this is not at this time.
Okay.
It will be when we consider the name.
Gotcha. Okay.
But right now, yeah, this is a non-action item, the comments, public comments. So it's not something we can make a decision, any kind of decision on.
Gotcha. Thanks. Thank you, Lily. Good idea. Okay, so without any additional comments, we can move on to announcements. Item number four.
Nothing from me.
Okay. All right, hearing nothing, we'll move on to item number five, the discussion about the possibility of using Hawaiian terminology instead of English descriptors in feature names.
So this has come up before. I think usually in a more specific way, talking about several specific different types of features. I can't think of any off the top of my head. But what I did was I printed up the GNIS feature classes, which I have to correct what I said, I think, at the last meeting where I said that they didn't include any Hawaiian terms, but looking through the descriptions for the feature classes, they do include a number of different Hawaiian terms.
Mm-hmm.
Moku, I remember seeing several others. So they are incorporated into the descriptions. But what we were talking about was a Hawaiian term, essentially a Hawaiian feature class as part of the name of the feature, not so much the feature class itself, but as part of the name. For example, a stream, or
right.
Again, I can't think of other examples, but using the Hawaiian term rather than the English term, because one of the alternatives that we've been adopting has been just dropping the English descriptor entirely where it was not ambiguous.
Mm-hmm.
So that's what this discussion is about. We're not going to make a decision today, but it's just to open the discussion about it. And again, unfortunately, we only have four members here. So I think we'd want more of the members present.
Yeah, I agree. You know, I think I've mentioned this in previous meetings, but I'm open. I think it's important when we're talking about a specific feature to have it there on the map. Because when lay people look at a map, they may not necessarily know what it is that they're looking at. So, but I'm not opposed to the idea of putting it in parentheses, for example, just sort of as an identifier of if you're talking about a particular gulch with a particular name, let's make sure that we know that the person who's looking at the name realizes that they're speaking about or looking at a gulch. So I'm not opposed to that. Using the Hawaiian descriptor, again, I'm not opposed to that as long as we have some kind of key that allows the layperson to figure out what it is that they're looking at. But yeah, I'm what are your thoughts, board?
I just wanted to chime in. I think I like the idea of adding Hawaiian words, place-based words and descriptors to the description of the feature class. And I think if it were in general, not for every single piece, because I think we look at everything case by case, but in general, my preference is to remove the descriptor. For instance, Oahu Island. I think that Oahu is sufficient, and it's captured in the feature class. And that island wouldn't necessarily need to be in the feature name, but could be captured in the feature class. And that along with island as a feature, it would also include the term mokupuni, as mokupuni is the Hawaiian term for what Oahu is as a feature class. And so I think we would have to be mindful about potential impacts of like making any sweeping changes. But I think in general, if we were to kind of look on a case by case basis, I think that that would make the most sense to me, and allows the opportunity to kind of have the name of the feature, and then have the description of the feature accessible in kind of the indigenous language of the place, and also understandable in English to other users.
So with respect to that, as I kind of glanced through, as you mentioned, island and mokupuni, it has in the GNIS feature class description has moku for stream, which we talked about last month. It has avava. For ridge, it has lai. So since we happen to have both Shelley and Jenny on the call, is there a process for suggesting, for us to suggest adding words to these descriptions from the feature classes?
That's a good question. The descriptions, I think, really are intended to be more like the generic term. So like, you know, pu'u would come up in under summit, along with, you know, hill and mountain and peak. And those are not the actual specific part of the name, but they're the generic part that we're talking about here. Those lists were developed, I'm saying, well over 3 decades ago, and I'm not aware of any additions. It's funny you should ask, because I was chatting with Bobby about a week or so ago, and he pointed out that one of the names on the list, he thought it should be Kipuka, and it has Kapula or something like that. I don't remember exactly the example he gave. And he said that's not a word he's at all familiar with. So it raised the question of, can I reach out to the GNIS staff to ask if they can modify or add to those lists? Seems to me it should be a simple database update, but it may be so embedded in the tables that it's maybe harder than I think it is. So I don't know the answer to the question, Arthur, but your question is timely because it's come up already just talking to Bobby. So let me look into that and let you know as soon as I can. I don't see why we shouldn't have some flexibility there and add some more. And if I could, back to Lily's comment, if I might, you know, the name is just the one official name that appears in the name field. Anything, we don't really have a way to show descriptions, sort of parentheticals, or it could be in the feature class. So if you looked it up in GNIS and you had the official name, you know, say the English generic was dropped or changed to a Hawaiian name. Now, the generic can be anything, doesn't have to be on that list. We do have a description field in GNIS, so that could be added, but that's not something you're going to see looking at a database download or a map. So, you know, if the intention is to modify the official name to strictly the Hawaiian name, that's perfectly fine. We want to recognize local use and preference, of course, but there's no way to really show any descriptor in parentheses. Does that make sense? the name is the name. Everything else is kind of incidental fields in the database. But I guess until we get to real examples at a future meeting, maybe it'll make more sense.
Go ahead, Meyer.
Are you sure? Well, she was addressing you. You go ahead, Lily, and I'll bring up an example after.
Well, I was just going to mention kind of I'm looking at the GNIS feature classes and kind of how it's described there. So I think what I was proposing was not necessarily adding additional feature classes.
Okay.
That would be Hawaiian words, but capturing the Hawaiian word in the description of the feature class itself.
Oh, I see. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. So okay. that would be mine. And then I would really appreciate it if you could follow up about potentially changing the description of some of these feature classes, because as I look at them, there's, so for instance, in here under stream, there's a Hawaiian word, avava, and it's not to say that that's incorrect, but that's not the prominent usage. The prominent like description for a stream would be a kahawai, because stream is typically in reference to the water. Avava is actually in reference to the land.
Oh,
so a stream can carve into the earth, and the vessel that it carves into the earth is the avava, but the flowing of the water is the kahawai. An avava would be a gulch that can be created by a stream.
Okay,
but the stream itself, the prominent or the dominant usage would likely be kahawai. And so that's where there's kind of misusages, I think, or it's been kind of miscaptured. Because like if you look up avava, it can refer to like a gulch or a stream, but it's in referring to the land, what's happening to the land, and not the actual water feature.
Right.
If that makes sense.
Oh, absolutely. That's a perfect example. Thank you, Lily, because this is something we talk about in the lower 48 as well, is there are states where a name is applied to a gulch, and for local people, they think the gulch is the water, whereas we would consider a gulch to be a valley, as you say, the vessel. And so it sounds like if we could just move avava from stream to valley, it might be okay. Right, because it refers to the thing that holds the water.
So avava would be better under gulch.
Yeah. Okay.
And then like kahawai would be better under stream, because kahawai captures the water. It has vai in it, which means that it's a water reference. Okay. Kaha means to carve. So it's the water that carves.
Okay.
It's just a different orientation.
No, that makes sense. And so are there features in GNIS now that have avava as the generic term that really should refer to the gulch, not the water itself? I haven't looked in GNIS since we've been talking. Are there some that are probably misclassified? This is another side project probably, but could I ask that maybe you or Arthur or Meyer put this in an email to us so I can forward it on to the GNIS staff to ask them? I don't want to misrepresent the terminology here. Is it just a very informal summary of what you've just requested there? Yeah, that'd be great.
I think another example, just for transparency, another example is under CAPE. It includes a word called, which is spelled L-E-A, Lea. But I think that's a misspelling of lie, L-A-E. A lie is actually like a cape, a projection of land extending into a body of water. Okay. So yeah, just little things like that. And then Bobby's reference to Kepula, I think he was saying that might need to be Kipuka.
Yes, that's what he said in his email, and that's the one I was going to look into. Didn't get a chance to yet this week, but yeah. So again, if it's not too much to ask, if you could pop those examples into an email, it would make life, or put them in the minutes if that's acceptable. I mean, since we're recording it here.
Arthur, I'll make a short little list and then
Okay.
I'll send it to you folks via email.
That'd be
Great.
great. So I guess in your list you'll come across this, but under ridge it has lie. Is that appropriate?
I would have to look into it. There may be certain usages where it's referred to as a lie. For
And
instance,
Jenny.
there's a term mo'o, and mo'o most people know is a gecko, right? But it has all these other meanings, but mo'o can also mean ridge.
Okay. Yeah,
It's, that'd be a good addition.
yeah. Yeah. So yeah, certainly if you want to add any, put them in that same email if you could, and we might as well ask for everything all at once if we can. Thank
That
you.
may also have to be a work in progress
Okay.
as well. That might be like a project for the Hawaiian language program. Maybe we can pester Kapaa about that. That might be something that students could help with, is kind of taking these Hawaiian terms and making sure that the spelling is appropriate and then finding all the different iterations for
Yeah,
it.
yeah.
We are known for having many iterations of names, so it
Yeah.
could be a lengthy process.
Sure. Yeah, I've learned that, and again, this list is probably 30 years old. And given how much work you guys have done with, reviewing and correcting a lot of these names, I'm not surprised that it's an obsolete catalog. And so let's fix it, even if it's 30 years late. So thank you, Lily. This is great.
I was going to say, Jenny, I don't know that it's there's some of these additions for the Hawaiian term seem pretty recent because they have the kahako, like pohaku, and some of these others. So
Okay.
so they may be re fairly
Yeah.
recent
Good. Good. Okay.
additions. So,
Okay.
Lily, we needed you last week. That's when somebody had asked about Kipapa Gulch, about renaming Kipapa Gulch because to them it wasn't really a gulch. And
Oh, interesting.
when we looked at the maps, it seemed like it was maybe referring to the stream. And that's sort of what brought this whole, or one of the issues that brought up this whole review of feature classes or English descriptors came up. So very timely. Glad you're here this week.
All right, great conversation. You actually got to the crux of my comment, so I will keep my mouth shut.
I had some concerns about the use of the maps. How many people use the USGS maps now? Because when I was younger, I'll show my age, I used to hike and I needed the USGS maps with me. And if I had gotten injured, someone coming to rescue me, I would hope that they could, if they didn't speak Hawaiian, know the Hawaiian language, if it was like a military person, I think it'd be nice for them to know it's a stream that they're coming to rescue me from. That would be my concern.
Yeah, when that makes sense. There's sort of the purpose, right? You're trying to give people a tool that everyone's looking at the same thing and understanding what it is that they're looking at. So we just need to make sure that there's enough keys so that someone familiar with the Hawaiian language and someone who is not, they both can come to the same conclusion. So just something to keep in mind. And that goes to my concern about getting rid of, for example, Aimu'u Gulch. We were talking about that earlier. If you get rid of Gulch, for example, and just name it Aimu'u, because that's the name, if people are not familiar with the area or not familiar with the feature, they won't know what it is that they're looking at. So, in the case that the example Holly gave, if you say, I'm in Aimu'u, well, I don't know, somehow you convey that you're in a location, but someone needs a map to figure out where that is, they might not know that Aimu'u is a gulch. So, I think in past meetings, we've talked about putting that feature not as part of the name, because the name isn't Aimu'u Gulch in this example, but rather Aimu'u, but in parentheses, Gulch afterwards, so that people know, okay, we're looking for Aimu'u, which is a gulch. If we take away that tool, people who are not familiar with looking at maps or not familiar with the area might not have the tools, so to speak, to figure out what it is that they're trying to find. But I'm not opposed to pulling Gulch out of Aimu'u if the name of the gulch is just Aimu'u. We just want to keep that extra tool in there so people know what it is that they're looking at, to my mind.
Yeah, thanks both of you. Yeah, Holly, that's exactly what was drilled into me when I started in this job, was we used to insist on an English generic on any proposal, because for exactly that reason. So the map user who maybe didn't speak the native language, and it's not just Hawaiian, but a lot of native languages in the lower 48 or Alaska for that matter. If someone doesn't know the type of feature and you're looking at a map and you're lost, you're calling 911, and that was, it was almost a requirement historically. And you know, how many people use USGS maps for hiking now? I think now people are on the Google Maps, but we just heard, you know, Google and Apple do rely on GNIS for the names. So if we update GNIS and they also update the name, that the challenge is, you know, yeah, putting Gulch in parentheses on a map, if it's not part of the name, it's not, there's not a mechanism right now to include it on a map. This would be a bigger philosophical discussion, I think, with USGS and mapping agencies in general, is what would the benefit be to put in the feature type in, you know, lowercase in parentheses, and where would it stop? Would every feature need a generic? I mean, not every name, even an English name, is obvious what kind of feature class it is. Philosophically, it is a very important discussion. You want to recognize the native name and local preference, but if you're catering to non-locals who don't speak the language or are calling 911, or, you know, of course, the answer now has been, well, you just, you know, you provide your GPS location. You know, nobody needs geographic names anymore. You just call in your GPS. Well, that's all well and good if you have a cell signal, but if you're out hiking and you're, you know, lucky to get that last little bit of bandwidth on your phone, you're going to use a place name, right? You're not going to use a geographic coordinate. So yeah, this is something that you should think about, the impacts, as you said, of this decision. And it may well be case by case. I mean, we look at, you know, Mount McKinley in Alaska got renamed to Denali. I think everybody probably knows what Denali is, right? It's just so famous, and you don't need to add mount to the name. It just, it has become its own identity. And there are many features, I'm sure, in Hawaii that are the same way, that have their own identity without a generic. But yeah, some of these more remote gulches and streams where it's not obvious, I don't know. Yeah, what are the consequences? So again, good discussion.
Thanks, Jenny.
Sure.
If there's no additional comments on this particular item, then we'll move on to the next one. All right, so item 6, discussion and decision on establishing a permitted interaction group to research the name of the island of Hawaii. So last meeting, we started a conversation about whether we should start a group, the pros and cons, and then who might be on this group. We also discussed cost, because you know, in order to, in this case, visit and talk to the people on the island of Hawaii, people got to go there, right? And that's going to cost money. And so there was a discussion of whether our individual agencies could fund that, or if the Office of Planning would have to do that. I don't know that there's a budget for that, but anyway, that's where we sort of left the conversation, because we didn't have a full board. And we don't have a full board today either, but any thoughts on establishing a permitted interaction group? And if so, who might want to serve on it? Okay, hearing none.
Well, I'll chime in. I'd be happy to, I think that it's a good idea if we're able to, and I'd be happy to contribute.
That's great. I think the initial conversation came about because, you know, obviously the discussion about the name of the island of Hawaii. And then the following meeting, you and Kapa were not able to attend. But I think from my point of view, I thought that particularly because the discussion was brought about between you and Kapa, that you and Kapa would be really good members of the group. One, your Olelo Hawaii is great, and mine is not. Two, I think, yeah, you guys have a strong interest in getting to the bottom of the name situation. So I think you guys would make great permitted interaction group members. Just my personal opinion.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I think it would be good to have a little bit of balance. So the comment that you made previously about Aimu Gulch, and like you would have some kind of concern about potential like secondary impacts of dropping Gulch and having it just be Aimu'u, and that changing, I think, the function or end use of the name, that is probably something that I wouldn't consider as someone who's not immersed in geography all the time, as like the center of my work, when it comes to like looking at different features and describing those features. And so I think it would be important to have other members who are strong in the kind of functionality of the geographic feature as well, just as like a check. I think Kapa is really good because her area of focus, or one of her many areas of focus in Olelo, is actually geographic based and geography based. And so she's kind of the pinnacle when it comes to knowledge about Olelo and that kind of cross section between language and geography. Whereas that's not something that I'm as knowledgeable in. And so something that we would want to be mindful about when selecting members of the PIG.
Agreed. Yeah, you bring up a good point. I mean, we're talking about maps here, and you want someone a little, at least geographic centric in their mindset. If it was something that the board felt that was important to have, I can always ask my supervisor if I can join the PIG, if that was something the board was interested in. I'm a surveyor. All I do is think about maps and descriptions. So, you know, if necessary, unless Kapa feels she can handle it, I'm happy to volunteer as well.
Yeah. Mahalo.
Yeah.
Appreciate that, Meyer.
No worries.
And Meyer, I think you have a long family history too of in Hawaii. So I think, I mean, I don't want to minimize your knowledge, especially your place-based knowledge. So, you know, I think that's important too.
I appreciate that. Do come from a very long line of surveyors. So I'm the whitest Hawaiian you're going to meet as well too. So, since we don't have a full board, I would recommend that we just table this until we get a chance to have a full board discussion on establishing the PIG and then voting on who should be on the PIG. Also trying to get to the bottom of exactly what it is that the group would be doing, what the mission was. I think there was we had some back and forth about discussing the idea of having the Okina in Hawaii. And I know, Arthur, some of your concern was that it might get off the topic of just the name itself, but my feeling was that the spelling is incorporated with the name. And so having a discussion of whether there's an Okina in the, you know, the name of Hawaii, I think is on the same level as how are we going to officially refer to the island of Hawaii. So
I think they're still back and forth because you know, you sort of express what my concern is that yes, that is one of the considerations in the name of the island, is whether or not there's going to be an Okina there. But when you broaden that to include the state or the state seal, that's more of a statewide issue and also not our Kuleana. So that's where my concern is, that if you approach it from sort of the narrow focus of what is the name of this island, and then what's the word I'm looking for? Extend that or scale that up to the state.
Mm-hmm.
That's a different community. Then, you know, it's not, we're not just going to the island of Hawaii. Then it's really the whole state. And then the second concern is that that's not our Kuleana. We've already done the research on the name of the state, and that is something that the legislature needs to address. The state seal is, I don't even know whose Kuleana that is. But those are applications, yes, of putting the Okina in Hawaii or not. But they are slightly different topics. So for us, I think where we've come across Hawaii or other words in place names, that's what we've addressed. We haven't extended that statewide. So even if there's a similar place name on a different island that has an Okina or a Kahako, we have not said, okay, we're going to use that here on Oahu, or we're going to use that on Kauai. We've, you know, said we'll do more research to find out why this name is here on this island. So, I mean, it's a little bit different than Hawaii in Hawaii Island or Island of Hawaii.
Sure.
But that's my concern, is that we're sort of stepping outside. Number one, we're stepping outside our Kuleana. And number two is we're kind of diluting this the scope of the PIG, the focus of the PIG. It's really to address this narrow issue, at least in my mind. But as you say, I think we need, you know, more of the board members to really talk through this. But yes, that's one of the things we need to talk through about the PIG before we can establish a PIG.
Understood. Thanks, Arthur.
Yeah, I agree. I think that's an interesting kind of interesting way of framing the conversation. I think that's not something that I had actually thought about as far as implications of adjusting the name / spelling for the island and its implications on the state. I think for me, maybe it's more along the lines of what Meyer was speaking to, that I think in contemplating the name of the island, you would need to contemplate how that would be spelled. And to me, that sounds like something that's like a reasonable thing to be included in the discussion and in the decision making. I think that it also, yeah, I think we would have to be really clear about the scope as far as what the potential change would impact, and that it would kind of clearly be impacting a singular feature to ensure that it's not beyond our kind of Kuleana, that we understand we're talking about a singular feature. And I honestly think that it will make it a lot easier when contemplating spelling about that singular feature, because there's so much debate about whether I mean, even like how Hawaii became the name of the Paiaina of the islands, right, is a very political conversation, even pre-contact, you know, like that was a, there's arguments about whether, you know, like what that name was and what the origin of it was. So yeah, I think something that would help the conversation is actually ensuring that our scope is clear, that we're contemplating this singular feature and not kind of stepping out of the bounds of what our Kuleana is. And then in doing that, I think just because it could have potential impacts on other things as far as impacting the way that people think about it, or raising the question of, well, if the island is spelled this way, then why is the state not spelled that way? I think that we shouldn't not move in order to avoid kind of future contemplation on things outside of the scope. Like I wouldn't want to be frozen in like, oh, I don't think that we should make this adjustment because it will bring up this other discussion about this other feature. I would want to kind of be more progressive in like identifying the constraints of the conversation and identifying the constraints of the scope, acknowledging kind of these potential externalities, but still, you know, making movement if there's a desire to do so. And I think part of that PIG will have to contemplate appropriate consultation and what that might look like, and how to include community, how community voices can be incorporated, especially since we are Oahu centric. Yeah, like I'm on Oahu, most of us are all based on Oahu. And so we have to be mindful that Oahu voices making decisions for Hawaii island of Hawaii, you know, making decisions that way, that is not an accepted narrative or a preferred narrative for all of our communities that reside on Hawaii Island. And so whether we're empowered as a board, we'll also have to contemplate whether we are empowered from the community or have the capacity to do appropriate consultation, to kind of look into it. So yeah, I think definitely need a full board discussion, and the PIG may, I'm not certain that the PIG will come out with a clear answer or recommendation, or if it will just end up with a lot of really deep conversation about Koleana and potential outcomes. So, but mahalo for this conversation.
Yeah, thanks, Lily. You know, to my mind, the job of the PIG is to interact and get feedback from everyone that they're meeting. So while the PIG has a specific mission, you know, it doesn't make the decision on its own. It gathers information, presents to the board. And so I think, yeah, we should go with an open mind, open ears, let people tell us what they think. That's the point. And then we summarize it, and then we come back and talk to the board about it. But yeah, to your point, full board obviously is best, so we'll go ahead and table this for now, and hopefully we can get a full board next meeting.
Yeah, and so I'll make a formal motion. I move that we table this to the next meeting, or the next meeting where we have either all board members or at least 5 board members present.
Great.
Seconded.
Okay, moved by Arthur, seconded by Lily. Any discussion? Hearing none, all those in favor say aye or raise your hand.
Aye.
Aye. Okay, motion carried. All right, we will go on to item number 7, discussion and decision on selected feature names on Oahu. And these are the same names that we looked at last meeting. But I know Keith and I wanted to get a little more time to do some research. Let's see. I'm trying to find it.
I don't think Bobby's on the call. He was going to have his conversation or follow up with Pulke Novemeyer.
Oh, that's right. Regarding Punch Bowl. That's Punch right. Bowl. Yeah. Let me see. I do it that. Okay. Well, I did look into, where the heck are the names? Sorry, one second. So I started with Alapena, and I did find that my office has a few maps specifically of this area. They just don't have the names, so it doesn't do us any good. but I did find a file plan that was done in the early 1900s, I think 1912, file plan 184, that does show the spelling as being Alapena. Alapena Pool, I believe, specifically. And Keith's not here, so he clearly can't tell us how his research went. I want to bring up the file plan. Stand by. File plan. There's Kapena up around the corner. We have lots of maps clarifying that. But Alapena Pool or Alapena Falls, as some maps show, more modern maps show. I couldn't find anything, you know, earlier than the 1900s. A file plan. Sorry, one second. 184. Coming up. 184 here. And I can share my screen. Can I share my screen?
Let me enable that. Hang on.
Sure. Is 1917.
Okay, you should be good.
Okay, thanks. Let me share screen. Pick the screen. Share. Okay, can you guys see the map?
Yes.
Here, so here's Kapenapool, here's Alapenapool in Nuuanu. This map's from 1917. Like I said, I got a lot of maps in the early 1880s that show this stream and pool. They even named Kapenna Pool on registered map 1784, but nothing really called out Alapenna. I checked the field books and I couldn't find any other reference. So this is kind of a newer map, 1917, but it's at least some support for the spelling.
Yeah, it's one of the three pools that were in that area. I have some maps because it's right next to the Royal Mausoleum.
Yeah, the Royal Mausoleum.
This is a
Oh,
state
yeah.
park. So I have a collection of them. I can try
Great.
to look to see if there's any clarification there.
Okay. I can also try to pull Grant 3691 because it abuts the pool and see if there's a reference to the grant. And, given that the grant's fairly youngish and only the 3000 series, that might be a good older source for the name as well. Great. Okay, I'll stop sharing now. All right, thanks.
Not sure my maps will solve anything, but
Well, I mean, if they support what my map shows, at least we have something to say that this is at least what we believe is the correct spelling without something contradicting it, right? The next name that I was able to find was Alau Gulch, but I couldn't find Gulch. I could only find Alau. And the same is for the next name, Ale. They're actually in the same area, all in Wailua. And Alau and Ale both show up on registered map 1784. And I can bring that up as well.
it's one of the gulches and state parks, the kind of point. So I
Is it?
just, if allow means branch, that's one of the definitions. It is one of the gulches where the streams come down and they do branch at one point.
That makes sense. The map
Kind of makes
actually.
sense. I'm not sure if that means that
Oh,
much, but yeah.
no, it's good to know. Yeah. 1784. What's interesting is the map has names of other gulches, so it puts the name plus gulch. But for these two, I don't know. They might be the name of trig stations that are along the gulch, and so they didn't call it gulch. I'll bring it up. Sorry, 1784. But I figure I'll show the board.
I think it's a fairly old name because it shows up with the way people would land along
Oh,
the
yeah. All
coast. So
right, let me try share this
I'll try
again.
to look that up too.
Okay, so here's Kaena and I go away. Uh-oh, I can't zoom in. Oh, there we go. Okay. Sorry if I'm going too fast. So here's Alau here. And there's a number of other names, but they appear to be, they're not trig stations. I don't see the triangle, but you can see like there's this one here. This is Manini Gulch. They
That's a good one.
have it of the mind to put gulch here, but they don't put it here. But based on the location of Alau and GNIS, I'm pretty sure this is the same location that we're looking at in Kaena.
Yeah.
And then if you scroll down this way, here's Alay here. I'll zoom in. This one definitely has a trig station next to it, or it's the name of the trig station itself there. But the spelling is how we've got it in GNIS. Oh.
I think it was a place name, and then they applied it to different features there.
Yeah.
It was a gulch, whether it was a trig station,
Yeah.
whether
So
it
and
was a
so
landing. The landings are important along there.
Right. And the surveyors knew that And that is kind of a fairly common naming convention where they know where they're at and they've got to drop an important trig station, so they'll just name it after the feature that they're at. Or if it's important to the ELE or OPWA, they'll just name it after that as well. But you can see there's a number of points along this grant line or these grant lines, these boundaries. But so I can't tell you for sure that this is the gulch and the, what is that, a pully in these areas, but the naming is, the spelling is at least correct, at least how we've got it allow as well. So, and this is registered map 1784. Okay, I'll stop
Would
sharing.
we have enough information then to maybe challenge the feature class of Alais? Or I don't know, I'm wondering about are we able to look up, or slash maybe I should do that right now, the other names that are in there, because it was like Alau, Alais, Kole. There was one that was like Kole Kole something. But I'm just wondering, that map shows them all kind of consistently as if they are the same type of feature. So I'm wondering if they're all the same feature.
Well, it's hard to say because this map might not be calling out the feature itself. Like Alais on this map, they appear to be calling out the trig station Alais. Whereas there may be the Alais pully somewhere nearby that's just not shown on the map. So I don't know for sure. I don't have enough information to say that the surveyor maybe misnamed it, because he might have been talking about a completely different feature. And again, as an example, Alais is a trig station here, but the pully itself could be further back and just not shown on the map.
What about the one that's adjacent to it? I think it had rocks in the
Yeah,
name.
sure. Let me pull that up again.
Yeah, can you pull that up again?
I
I'm
sure
just
can.
wondering
No problem.
what your mana'o is, the Holoi Honua
Yeah. Oh, I
Mea. Is
gotta wait.
that a part of the name, or it says rocks, or is it two separate things that just are reading as the same?
That's a great question.
Yeah, so interesting.
Yeah, they've capitalized rocks, so
It would be a name.
I would consider it part of the name. Yeah.
Okay.
Generally, they might just be, sometimes they'll point out there are rocks in this area. It might be an ahu or whatever, but if it's not part of a proper noun, they won't capitalize it generally. So,
Interesting.
there's a field book associated with this. I will pull the field book and see if there's a reference to the shot that they took, and see if there's any additional information about that particular location.
Cool. Thank you so much, Meyer.
Yeah. And then a field book to 196. Okay. Holoi Honuamea. Rocks. Okay.
Emerson do the map?
I'm sorry.
Emerson did one of the maps, didn't he? Well,
I believe so. This
yeah,
one.
he did the grants because he split up the grants. We're all along the shoreline.
Oh yeah.
And Emerson, no, his description's really interesting.
Yeah. Well, we can try to pull some of these up if you want to look at them. Let's see. So here's another one, Pohakuloa Rock, and with a mark on it. And then there's Pohakuloa here with the trig station. There's something significant about the rock though, unless, yeah, I don't know enough. There's Pohakumana Rock, so there's some more over here. Pohakumana is the trig station. So there might, Pohakuloa Rock might be the feature in the area, and he just named the trig station because he's associated next to it, Pohakuloa. And same with Pohakumana. Yeah, I'll try to pull some of the information from the field notes and see if there's some more information about the naming convention he used for this. can try to pull up Kipuka too and see if we want to take a look at the grant. I don't know if that's something the board wants to do, is sit through and read grants. Not everybody gets their kicks out of that like I do. So
he was trying to preserve the native rights to certain, well, like to collect salt, dry nets. He listed a list of things that they should still have access to, even if they weren't the grant owner. So I thought that was really interesting.
Yeah, no, that's smart.
Yeah.
I mean, that was part of the mission of the survey office at the time, too, was to preserve all of this. I mean, it was a kingdom office before it was ever associated with the United States.
I wouldn't have thought of drawing nets. Or landing as well. They could land there.
Yeah. Well, the beauty of this is that these are made at, you know, in this time. So the importance of it was clear to the surveyor at the time. And generally, they were going around with Kama'aina explaining all this to them. So they had a lot access to a lot more information in their heads. This is some of, so the field books aren't as complete with all this information as I would like. In the head of the surveyor, they got a whole story as to why they're doing this, why they're using these name conventions. But if they don't put that down somewhere, like, as you said, Emerson did, created a list and gave reasons why he was naming things. For us, looking back, we have no way to get that knowledge out without just repeatedly looking at these things and sort of coming to some kind of conclusion based on what we observe. And even then, we're kind of guessing. So anyway, I'll stop sharing. Sorry. Okay. And lastly, Ani Ani, I think Ani Ani Nui Ridge was one of the names. I was unable to find reference to Ani Ani Nui Ridge, but I did find Ani Ani on registered map 72. It appears to be referencing Ani Ani Nui Ridge, but I don't know if it's always been known as Ani Ani Nui Ridge or if that came about later. I'll bring up registered map 72. 72, here we go. And I'll pull out a little bit there and I'll share. There we go. So this is register maps 72. And I'm going to zoom in here as soon as this, there we go. You can see reference to Ani Ani here. But that's the only, and we don't have a heck of a lot of maps in this area, or some of them are island wide. And so they just didn't think to put these names of smaller features in on the map. But this one, thankfully, I was able to dig up. It's a fairly older map, 72. But the spelling, Ani Ani, is how we spell it. Granted, there's no diacritics, but you're not going to find any on any of these maps anyway. So, and that's all I found. I think there's a couple of other names on there. I was not able to dig anything up, at least not in my records for these features and these names. Buddy, this is my great, 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 great grandfather, J.A. Cummins, leased a lot of this from the kingdom and had purchased a number of grants in this area as well. So I always like looking at Waimanalo. Anyway, that's what I got.
So some of the research, when I was looking into it, Papakilo database and Ulukau database, they both have it as Ani Ani Nui.
Okay.
But they're also referring to the USGS map. That's what they cite as the source. And then Ani Ani is referenced as well in a few different locations, both on Ulukau, I don't think on Papakilo, but Ani Ani is talked about in reference to Mauna Wili. And being in that location. So I wasn't able to find kind of definitive references to it. The only kind of section that I didn't look up so far would be if I look in the new PEPA and see if there's any references to Ani Ani or versus Ani Ani Nui. I mean, ideally, we would want to find an article that has both Ani Ani and Ani Ani Nui and explains the difference between the two. But yeah, so that's kind of one piece that I think I still need to look into to see if we might be able to get some more references.
Great. All right, I'm going to stop sharing. Thanks, Lily. Okay. Okay, so that's all I've got for names. And seeing that as we've reached the end of that list, I don't know if there's any votes to be had at this point, since we're sort of inconclusive. We have partial evidence suggesting that what we're showing is might be correct, but still inconclusive. So maybe just more research. We'll just leave it at that for now.
Well, so what I heard was Alapena Pool. Mm-hmm. There's some other places you're going to look, the grant, and then
yes,
you're going to look at something.
I'll look at the Kaiana one as well as the one that's Kapana. Because they're state parks.
Okay.
So I've had to do something with them one time or another.
So none of, are any of these, do we want to mark any of these? We've exhausted all our resources. And so we're going to take away the three and make it a seven.
You know, I haven't
of a Nui Gulch.
I haven't. I want to pull out the field book for registered map 1784 regarding Alao Gulch and Ale Pali. So let's not put that as being exhausted just yet. And Alapena, we're going to look at the grant, and Holly's got some maps, so let's not change that yet. Ani Ani, I've looked at everything. So, but it sounds like Lily is willing to check the new paper, and we'll see what we can get out of that.
Yep, I can do that.
Great. So maybe we just leave it at threes for now.
Okay. Okay, then you'll see the same. And Api Spring and Awanui Gulch, leave those as well.
Those I could not find anything. I'm tapped out on those. Yeah.
I think that I would like another chance to take a look.
Okay, so you'll deal with the same list next month.
Thank you.
We are nothing if not thorough.
Yeah. Well, I'm not going to add 10 more is
okay.
Sort of what I'm saying. Is that,
gotcha.
We'll leave it at this. Okay.
Okay. So seeing as there's no additional items on the agenda, I'm tempted to move to adjourn unless there's additional. Oh, did we want to talk with Shelley? Did Shelley want to speak a little bit?
At least meet her.
Hi, everyone.
Hi.
Sorry, I was going to try to be there in person today, but I woke up feeling a bit under the weather. So hopefully next month I'll see you all in person.
Okay.
So I'm in about my, I think this is the fifth week I've been in this role. So I'm the new executive secretary for the Board on Geographic Names, Domestic Names Committee. So all of the decisions that you all are making here, it's in my kuleana to make sure that we work with the DNC to get those decisions input into the GNIS system so that we're all on the same page. And I'm really excited to work with you all and just listen into the discussion today. It's very exciting. And feel free to reach out anytime if you have any questions. I'll be happy to chat. And yeah, mahalo.
I appreciate
Thanks,
you being here. Yeah, I appreciate both you and Jenny. Mm-hmm. So thank you.
Yeah, thanks, guys. So it should be an exciting meeting next meeting, hopefully, if we can get enough board
we
members.
get everybody, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. But otherwise, yeah, looking forward to it. If there's no additional items to discuss.
I'll move to adjourn.
Okay, motion made by Arthur to adjourn. Any
I'll
second?
Second.
All right, seconded by Holly. Any discussion? Okay, good. all right, well then, hearing nothing, all those in favor of adjourning, say aye or raise your hand.
Aye.
Okay, motion passed. Thank you, everyone, for tolerating me chairing this meeting. I appreciate
Good job.
It.
Good job, Meyer.
Thank you very
Thank
much.
You.
All right, so this meeting is adjourned at 3:13 p.m. You guys all have a wonderful rest of your day, and I will see you next month.
Ahui ho.
Okay.
Aloha,
Aloha,
everyone.
Aloha, guys.